The bike you'll use here is more agile and has much better acceleration. But unless you know how to use it, you'll spend most of your time on the ground. This next lesson is focused on getting you familiar with the new bike's handling and to teach you one of the key riding techniques, the bunny hop. A bunny hop is where you'll use your body weight to make the bike jump over large gaps or up to higher ledges. The bunny hop is the most important technique to learn, so even if you've skipped over other lessons, pay attention to this one. To get an understanding of what's happening, consider that your rear suspension is a spring, and the more pressure you apply, the harder it bounces back. This release of pressure and shifting your body weight will make the bike jump. As you start accelerating, sit back on the bike and load the suspension to build up potential energy. Pay attention to the load on the rear suspension, and when it's at its maximum, release the pressure by leaning forward. The timing of these two movements is crucial to get right. Experiment with slight adjustments of the timing of each until you feel confident with the bunny hops you're performing. The final part of the bunny hop is designed to maximize the height of your jump. Lean back to load the suspension, lean forward to release the pressure, and then quickly lean back again. What you'll see is that this final step will lift the bike underneath you and ensure that the back wheel doesn't hit anything. The next track will test how well you've understood the bunny hop by making you clear bigger and bigger gaps. You won't get far unless you've understood this lesson, so take your time and let me know if you need any help.
I tried to make that last jump really big, and you managed to find a way through. A plus.
If you're watching this, you've chosen to be the best rider you can be, and wow, that gets me excited. As you've made it this far, it's time to ramp up the difficulty with the next lesson, uphill obstacles. For the purposes of this lesson, uphill obstacles refer to any time you approach a jump from an uphill slope or a ramp. If you haven't already figured this out, now is the time to truly master throttle control, which is where you use the gas very gently and only enough to maintain control without flipping backwards. Before you even get into this lesson, practice slowly going up and down at the start of this track, only using throttle control to maintain grip. Most steep inclines you come across can be passed by using this technique, so it's a very helpful thing to master. Where uphill obstacles get more complicated is when additional objects are included, such as a vertical section at the top. The technique here is to accelerate at the base of the ramp, but after you build up speed, ease off the gas. Only when your front wheel has cleared the obstacle, lean forward, and you'll get over the object.
If you hold gas all the way to the top, you'll be pushed backwards. And as you'll learn, sometimes going slower will actually be faster. As you get to the harder grades, there will be jumps where you don't seem to have enough height to get over them. The trick is to lean backwards and slam your rear wheel into the obstacle and then lean forward. But we'll cover that more in the next lesson. There is one last technique that is especially useful when climbing high objects. When only your front wheel is in contact with the object, press brake. This will allow your momentum to carry your bike over, and when the rear wheel is higher than the front, let go of the brake and roll forward. If you're having trouble getting the back wheel high enough, rapidly tap brake while accelerating and your rear wheel should rise up. This is a hugely important technique, but unfortunately, I can't say its name. Let's just call it flapping? On that note, let's get right into the next track. I honestly didn't think you'd make that, but you proved me wrong. A+! When you start riding more difficult tracks, you'll usually find a jump that you look at and say, "That's impossible." In my experience, it's just that you don't know the correct technique to use yet. One of the most common examples is the subject of the next lesson, flat obstacles. This technique focuses on passing an obstacle from a flat surface. This is more difficult as there is no ramp to assist you, so you'll need to use a different approach. When the obstacles are round, performing a bunny hop and leaning forward is often enough for the smaller jumps, but that doesn't work for square objects. If you try to bunny hop, you'll find it increasingly difficult to climb that high. So the tip is to slam the rear wheel and bike frame into the corner of the obstacle and then lean forward. If you get this right and with enough speed, your momentum will get you up and onto the obstacle. As the obstacles get higher, you'll have to do more to get the extra height required. Prior to performing a bunny hop, lean forward. What you'll notice is that when you lean back, there is extra pressure loaded on the rear suspension. And as we've covered previously, this increases the height generated from the bunny hop. When you combine leaning forward before the bunny hop and slamming your rear wheel and bike frame into the obstacle, you'll be climbing things you never thought you could. For the maximum height on a jump, rather than just leaning forward, performing an endo before the jump will give you a huge boost. An endo is performed by leaning onto your front wheel and balancing before the bunny hop. When you lean back for the bunny hop, you'll get a boost from the additional pressure on the rear suspension. That's good to remember, as you'll use it a fair bit now that you know about it. As any good professor knows, a lesson is only as good as the grade your students get, so make me proud. And as always, if you're struggling, you can ask for help. But don't forget to go back and improve on the prior lessons as well. I was so worried I'd made that last section too difficult, but you still managed to get it. Great work!